Alright, I want to talk about primer. There's a difference between 1K primer and 2K primer. I mean, there's other primers as well. There's epoxy, there's self-etching, it's a whole lot of stuff. But we're going to keep this video with 1K and 2K. So a 1K primer, get the job done. It's not super expensive and it's not super cheap. I guess you can get it cheaply. It depends on the brand. Depends on where you buy it. It's a lot of variables that go into that. 1K would be Duplicolor, or you can get a High Tech, you can get Rust-Oleum, you can get it definitely at like AutoZone, O'Reilly's, and the spray can. But they also do have, they do have a gallon where you can get it and you can spray it out of a spray gun. Okay, so like I said, it'll get the job done. As far as durability, it's not as strong as 2K. And to answer your question, yes, I have used 1K primer in the past. I don't use it no more. I haven't used 1K primer since my pricing went up, but don't get it twisted. 1K primer has its place. Also to add, 1K primer does not use a hardener. 2K primer uses a hardener. That's also why 2K costs more than 1K. So if you guys are wondering, what primer do I use for my paint jobs? We're using 2K primer. In some situations, we may need to use an epoxy and stuff like that, but for the most part, 2K primer, and even if we use epoxy, it's with a hardener. We're not using that cheap stuff. It's also why the price has gone up. It's one of those things like building a house. You can't build the house if the foundation is crappy.